नेक्स्ट वन, ए बाइकॉन्वेक्स लेंस इज फॉर्म्ड विथ two thin plano convex lenses. Refractive index of first lens is 1.5 and that of second one is 1.2. Both curved surfaces are of same radius of curvature14 cm. For biconvex lens, for this biconvex lens, object is 14 cm, then the image will be 14 cm. For this biconvex lens, object is at 40 cm, then the image will be. So that means here two plano convex lenses like this, F1 and this is F2. Assume like this. Okay, and this radius of curvatures, that means this radius of curvature of this surface and radius of curvature of the second surface are equal, and that equal to 14 cm. So for both these lenses, R is equal to 14 cm, and mu1 is 1.5 and that of mu2 is 1.2. So now if these two lenses are kept in contact such that we get a plano biconvex lens like this. That means we have to apply the combination of two lenses such that we can get the equivalent focal length. So for first one, 1 by F1 is equal to mu1 minus 1 into 1 by R. Similarly for second one, 1 by F2 is equal to mu2 minus 1 into 1 by R. Because second surface refractive radius of curvature is infinity, so we are directly writing this 1 by R. Now these two lenses are combined to form a single lens, then the equivalent focal length is. So for equivalent focal length, we have this formula, 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 by F2. So we can write it as, now this one. So as ready, mu1 is 1.5. So 1.5 minus 1 into 1 by R plus 1.2 minus 1 into 1 by R, because we are writing same R, because R is same 14 cm. So we can write 1 by R into 1.5 minus 1 is 0.5 plus 0.2, that is 0.7 into 1 by 14. So 1 and 20. So F equal to 20 cm. Okay. Now the equivalent focal length of these two, That means two plano convex lenses of different refractive indices are combined to form a single biconvex lens, and its focal length is 20 cm. Now, if this combination of these two lenses, object is at 40 cm, then the image will be. So, u is equal to given as 40 cm. For a convex lens, we have to take it as minus. And v is equal to question mark, f is equal to 20. Now we have the relation 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus u, that is 1 by v plus 1 by 40, that is 1 by 20 is minus 1 by 40 equal to 1 by v, implies 1 by v is equal to 40 minus 20, 20 by 20 into 40, that is 1 by 40. So v is equal to 40 . Now the 8th one. A parallel beam of light, parallel beam of light is incident from air at an angle alpha on the side PQ. Of right angled triangular prism of refractive index root 2, light emerges total internal reflection internally undergoes total internal reflection in the prism on the face PR . Then alpha has a minimum value (45°). The angle theta of the prism is 45°. The given diagram is PQR Okay, this is the given diagram and this is the problem. Okay, a parallel beam of light is incident from air at an angle alpha on the side PQ of a right angled triangular prism of refractive index root 2. Light emerges total internal, light undergoes total internal reflection on the prism on the face PR when alpha has a minimum value of 45, the angle theta of the prism is. Now assume that light is incident like this. So if you draw a normal like this, so incident light is this one. Okay, now it is refracted like this because it is air to denser medium. So in denser medium, refracted ray bends towards the normal. So like this, towards the normal, and incident at this point, assume that at this point T. So PQR, so assume that this is S and this is the point T. Now at this point T, if we draw a normal like this, okay, so that the given condition is the light undergoes total internal reflection on the face PR. That means here the light has to undergo total internal reflection. So this value must be minimum critical angle. That means here this angle of incidence must be critical angle. Minimum angle is critical angle so that it undergoes total internal reflection. So this is the minimum value. That means alpha becomes reverse maximum value. So assume that this angle is alpha. This angle is R for here. Alpha, this is R. And here we consider as an IC. If the angle of incidence here is critical angle, then it undergoes total internal reflection. Because it is light, here it is from denser to rarer. So here total internal reflection can take place. Now we have to find this theta. So, okay, how we can find this? Now first we apply the total internal reflection condition here. That means on the face PR, sine IC by sine 90. Actually, here it is taking undergoing total internal reflection. So, sine IC by sine 90 equal to 1 divided by root 2. Because this is the refractive index of this prism is root 2 and it is in air. So, air refractive index by prism refractive index. So sine 90 is 1, so sine IC is 1 by root 2, that implies IC is 45 degree. Okay, now on this surface PQ. On the face PQ, applying Snell's law, because here there is no total internal reflection. Applying Snell's law, sin I by sin R equal to mu 2. Now applying Snell's law here, sin alpha by sin R is equal to sin alpha by sin R is equal to refractive index of the second medium root 2 by 1. Okay, but given the maximum value for alpha is 45 degree, so sine 45 by sin r from this condition. So sin r, that is 1 by root 2 into 1 by root 2 is equal to sin r. So sin r equal to 1 by 2 implies r is equal to 30 degree. Okay, now we have to find this theta value. So to find this theta value, assume the triangle PST. PST, this triangle, from triangle PST, this is theta, okay, write down theta, plus here the angle S from here to here is, actually this is 90 degree to this surface, this is 90 degree, this dotted lines is 90, so 90 and again this is R, so total angle is 90 plus R, so angle S is 90 plus R plus here T and this is 90, the total angle is 90 and this is IC, so this angle is 90 minus IC, this total angle is 90 and this is IC, so this angle is 90 minus IC plus 90 minus IC, this is the three angles of this triangle, that sum is equal to 180, so we can cancel out these two, so theta plus R minus IC equal to 0, so theta is equal to IC plus R, sorry, minus R, but IC we have 45 and R we have 30, so 45 minus 30, that is 15 degrees. Okay, next one. In a Young double slit experiment, Young double slit experiment, one of the slit is wider than the other, so amplitude of light from one slit is double that of other. If IM is maximum intensity, IM is maximum intensity, then the intensity at a point they interfere at a phase difference. Phase difference phi. In a Young double slit experiment, one of the slit is wider than the other, so that the amplitude of light from one slit is double that of the other. If IM is the maximum intensity, then the intensity at a point where they interfere at a phase difference of phi. So we have the condition in this case, the amplitude of one source, if you take it as A, and the other source A2 as 2A, given that condition. Because second slit is wider, so that the amplitude of light from the second slit is double that of the first one. So we have the resultant intensity at a point I is equal to, we have this relation A1 square, A2 square, 2A1, A2 cos phi, where the phase difference is phi. Now here we can write A square plus 4A square plus 2 into A into 2A cos phi. That is 5A square plus 4A square cos phi. Okay. Now we can write it as A square into 5 plus 4 cos phi. Assume that like that. Okay. Next, given condition is I max is the maximum intensity, and this will be maximum, this intensity will be maximum when cos phi equal to 1 or phi equal to 0. So I max equal to, what we can write it as, A1 plus A2 whole square. So if cos phi is 1, I is equal to A1 plus A2 whole square. That is A plus 2A whole square. That is 3A whole square means 9A square. So from this we can write A square is equal to I max by 9. So here we can write it as, so I is equal to I max by 9 into 5 plus 4 cos phi. The answer is, further simplified, so we can write like this, and further, that means, so I is equal to Im by 9 into 5 plus 4 into, writing cos phi, 2 cos square phi by 2 minus 1. That is Im by 9 into 5 plus 8 cos square phi by 2 minus 4. So this equal to Im by 9, so 1 plus 8 cos square phi by 2. So I is equal to Im by 9, this is the condition. Okay, next one. Next one, 10th one. A young double slit experiment arrangement with slits S1 and S2 immersed in water. Of refractive index 4 by 3 as shown in figure, I will write. The position of maxima on the surface of water is given by x square equal to p square m square lambda square minus d square, where lambda is wavelength, in air refractive index 1, 2d the distance between the slits, m is an integer, then value of p. Okay, this is the given diagram. Young double slit arrangement with slits S1 and S2. S2 immersed in water. Of refractive index 4/3, as shown in figure. The position of maxima on the surface of water. This is the surface of water. At a particular position, x from the slits is given by, this is the condition. The position of maxima is found on the surface. So when 2d is the distance between the slits, m is an integer, then what is the value of p? Okay, actually this particular point O is given that it is a maximum, but it is not equidistant from these two slits, because this ray number 1, that means light ray from S1 is traveling in air, S2 is traveling in water. So they are traveling in two different medium. In that case, we have to take the optical length or optical path. So optical path is equal to original distance traveled multiplied by refractive index. So optical path of light in a particular medium is distance, that means original distance traveled multiplied by refractive index. So now if we consider both these two rays, and this second ray, light ray from second source is in water and light ray from first source in air. So the optical path for the S1P, we can write it as simply, suppose if this is the distance and this is x, and this S1O is equal to, from this triangle, square root of x square plus d square. This is the original distance by this Pythagoras theorem. But as it is in air and air refractive index is 1, so this is simply square root of x square plus d square. For second one, S2O, we have to write original distance is x square plus d square. It is also same, but it is traveling in water of refractive index 4/3. So it is multiplied by 4/3. So the path difference S2O minus S1O is equal to 4/3 square root of x square plus d square minus square root of x square plus d square. So taking this as common term, square root of x square plus d square into 4/3 minus 1, that is so path difference, what we can say, delta is equal to this square root of, sorry, this is 4/3 minus 1 is 1/3. So 1/3 into square root of x square plus d square. But given that at any point on this particular water surface, we get maximus. So maximum condition is path difference equal to n lambda. So for maxima, delta is equal to n lambda. So writing this here, so n square, so n lambda is equal to 1 by 3 square root of x square plus d square. Squaring on both sides, n square lambda square is equal to 1 by 9 into x square plus d square. Now, writing here, 9 n square lambda square is equal to x square plus d square. So writing this, x square is equal to 9 lambda square n square minus d square. Now the given condition is this one, x square is equal to this. So comparing these two, already it is given m is an integer. Here also we are taking n as integer. So comparing these two implies p square is equal to 9 implies p is equal to 3. Now 11th one, two coherent monochromatic sources point sources S1 and S2 wavelength are placed symmetrically on either side of center of circle, center of a circle shown in figure. They are separated by d is equal to 1.8 mm. Okay, there are four options are given. Number one, total number of fringes between P1 and P2 in the first quadrant is close to 3000. Number two, a dark spot is formed at P2. And third one, at P2, order of fringe is maximum. And fourth one, the angular separation between consecutive bright spots decreases. As we move from P1 to P2 along first quadrant, these are the options given, and the diagram given is like this. So, okay, now given that the two sources are symmetrically on either side of the center of the circle, and P1 and P2 are two given spots like this. So, now if we consider at P1, what we can observe is P1, these light rays from these two sources travel equal distance because they are symmetrically on either side of the center. So here the path difference delta x is 0, means P1 is bright. Okay, P1 is bright. Now if we consider P2, now the path difference from these positions is S1P minus S2P. Okay, from here at P2, next condition, at P2 delta x equal to S1P2 minus S2P P2. That means S1P2 minus S1P2 means S1S2, that equal to S1S2, because S1P2 minus S1P2 is S1S2, but S1S2 is 1.8. Now, this is the difference between the two sources. Now, writing this difference in terms of this one. Okay, writing that, we can write, what we can write is d by lambda, what one write. So, 1.8 by 600 nanometer, and this is millimeter, 10 power minus 3, and this is 10 power minus 9. Just breaking ratio. Okay, now we can cancel out this minus 6 and another 2, minus 4. So 0.3. So 0.3 into 10 power minus 4, sorry, plus 4. That is 3 into 10 power 3, that is 3000. So D is equal to 3000 into lambda. So D, that is 1.8, that is path difference. So path difference is an integral multiple of lambda. That means P2 is also bright. Okay. Now see the, we can see the options. First one, that means if this is zero order and this is 3100, that means total in the first quadrant there are 3000, nearly 3000 fringes. So because first order is 1 lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda, 4 lambda, 5 lambda. Now at this position we get 3000 lambda. That means totally in this first quadrant we get about 3000 fringes. So total number of fringes between P1, P2 in the first quadrant is on. This is right one, correct option. A dark spot is formed at P2. No, bright spot is formed at P2. So this option is wrong. Next, at P2 the order of fringe is maximum. So now for any position at this position, the fringe number may be, like, suppose if you take this one 0, so now 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. This may be 2999. So the maximum order is 3000. So this is also correct one. Next, angular separation between the consecutive bright spots. For this, we can calculate like this. Now, suppose for a particular angle theta at any position, for this position, the path reference is given by d sin theta is equal to n lambda. Okay. If theta is 0, we get the path reference is 0. If theta is 90, we got d is equal to n lambda. So in that case, we have verified. Okay. Now, to find the angular separation, variation of angular separation as we move from P1 to P2. That means we have to differentiate with respect to order, because we are moving from this position to this position. We are moving, that means we need two consecutive bright bands, angular separation. That means we have to differentiate this n. So we can write it as d cos theta d theta is equal to dn lambda. So d theta by d lambda is dn is equal to lambda by d cos theta. Okay. Now, as we move from P1 to P2, theta value 0 to 90. That means theta value changes from 0 to 90. At the same time, cos value changes from 1 to 0. That means cos value is decreasing, means d theta value, this value is increasing, inverse proportion. But here it is given as decreasing. So this option is wrong. Now the last one, fourth one. The angular width, of central maximum in a single slit diffraction pattern is 60 degree. The width of the slit, is 1 micrometer. Okay. When illuminated by monochromatic light, if another slit of same width, is placed near it, young double slit fringes, Young's fringes are formed. On a screen placed at 50 centimeter from the slits. It is observed that the fringe width is one centimeter. What is the slit separation? Okay, the angular width of a central maximum in a single slit diffraction pattern is 60 degree. The width of the slit is 1 micrometer when illuminated by a monochromatic light. If another slit of same width is placed near it, young double fringes are formed on the screen, 50 centimeter from the slits. it is observed that the fringe width is 1 cm, what is the slit separation? So for a single slit diffraction, we have the condition like this. This is first minimum and this is first minimum. And in between this, we get central maximum. So this angular width of this central maximum is this total angle. That means like this. That means this is given as 60 degree. But the condition for the first minimum is d sin theta is equal to, or a sin theta is equal to, we have n lambda. N lambda means n equal to 1. This is the condition for first minimum on one side. So another side. So if this angle is total 60 degree, then half of this angle is 30 degree. So a sin 30 is equal to lambda. That implies given a is width is 1 micrometer. So 1 into 10 power minus 6 into half is equal to lambda. So lambda is equal to 0.5 into 10 power minus 6 meter. So this is given. Now another slit is placed, similar slit is placed along with it, so that we get a young double slit experiment arrangement, so that interference fringes are formed. And those fringes are observed from 50 cm and width of those fringes is 1 cm. So fringe width beta is equal to, we have registration lambda d by 2d. This is fringe width in young double slit experiment. So 1 cm is 10 power minus 2. And lambda we have calculated from this condition, 0.5 into 10 power minus 2. And separation between the slits and the screen is 50 centimeters. So 50 into 10 power minus 2 by 2D, separation of the slits. So then one can be cancelled out. That is 2D is equal to 0.5 into 50 into 10 power minus 2. And this is 25 into, sorry, this is minus 6. 10 power minus 6. Okay, this is cancelled. 10 power minus 6. That is 25 into 10 power minus 6. Therefore, separation is 25 micrometer.